stage.
Accueillons la présidente, Rebecca Blaikie.
Bonjour tout le monde et bienvenue à
Edmonton.
Well, my friends, it's been a very interesting 5 years. We've been through a lot together over the past 5 years, some very tough times, even some very sad times, and also some very, very exciting times. And I thank you for being a part of all of that over this time with me. Au cours des cinq dernières années, j'ai eu la chance de rencontrer des milliers de néo-démocrates partout au pays. Ça a été un grand privilège. Notre mouvement est fort et plein de gens passionnés et formidables. J'ai travaillé fort pour servir les intérêts de nos membres et de notre parti à titre de présidence. Je peux vous avouer que ça n'a pas toujours été facile, durant les hauts et les bas, j'ai toujours considéré mon mandat comme un grand honneur et j'ai fait de mon mieux. Over the past months, I've traveled the country listening to New Democrats, and I'll have an opportunity to go into a little bit more depth about that with you later in the session on the campaign debrief. The report is available for those who haven't seen it yet on the NDP website, and I encourage you to read it and to participate in the session later today. I'm proud of the report. I'm proud of the work that went into it. I think it's honest and constructive, and I hope very much that it will be used by all of you going forward as a tool for progress as we move forward together as a political family. Notre objectif au NPD, c'est d'agrandir notre famille et d'élargir le cercle des gens, de créer un environnement où tous les Canadiens et Canadiennes se sentent appréciés et inclus dans notre société. Certains vont dire qu'on est des rêveurs, mais ils nous ont toujours dit ça à chaque fois qu'on partage nos bonnes idées, notre vision, nos rêves. And you'll hear it, probably hearing it this weekend, same old thing. They're chomping at the bit to relegate us to history. But I'm here to tell you right now that the NDP is not going anywhere! We will continue to dream no little dreams. We will continue to work together all across Canada to realize those big dreams together. And I have faith in you, I have faith in us, and we're going to move forward this weekend together. Which is the impression that seems to be out there that the word socialism was somehow taken out of our constitution at the last convention. Far from it, our democratic socialist and social democratic principles were affirmed as part of the great tradition from which we continue to draw strength and inspiration. Les néo-démocrates veulent un avenir à l'image des idéaux et des objectifs des Canadiens qui, suivant nos traditions social-démocrates et socialistes-démocratiques, ont œuvré au sein des mouvements agricoles, ouvriers, coopératifs, féministes, environnementalistes, des Premières Nations, Indiens, Inuits et de défense des droits de la personne dans l'espoir de bâtir un Canada plus juste, plus équitable et plus respectueux de l'environnement au sein d'une communauté internationale qui partage ses objectifs. Moi, je suis fière de notre constitution. We need to continue to say, perhaps quite excitingly, given what's happening around the world, with more people being willing to listen than ever before, given the many egregious failures of neoliberalism throughout my lifetime, that the market is not God. New Democrats. New Democrats say no to the corporate model of globalization. No to a global flea market where our social and economic values are traded away in a race to the bottom, and in trade agreements like the TPP that are designed to limit the power of governments to act in the public interest and to restrict the ability to respect the rights of Indigenous peoples. We say no.
anything else I can do?
You Democrats say yes to enforceable core labor standards for all workers of the world, and no to a global economy that only enforces profits instead of workers' rights. Because we can't have incremental justice, because as Cindy Blackstock said, there's no such thing as an incremental childhood, and Indigenous children need equality today. Canadians need a government that is willing to face the challenge of climate change, not just a government that can use all the right buzzwords, hold all the right meetings, and facilitate all the right press conferences, but a government that will take real, concrete action and who is willing to have the tough conversations like we're having here this weekend together about what we actually need to do at this juncture to begin to transition our economy for the future. But who don't give us their political loyalty. Let's get to the bottom of why that is and see if there are acceptable changes that we can make that could make that more possible, that we can consider together. We need to be a more activist party that informs and empowers its members to shape the conversation in their communities, the coffee shops, the gurdwaras, the mosques, the churches, and the hockey rinks. Environmental groups with I Don't Know More and Black Lives Matter. While also always in that work making the critical case for the importance of electoral politics and the differences that can only be made at the ballot box. And that's why we need the NDP. The role of the NDP in federal politics over the decades has been to speak truth to power. Why we've often been called the conscience of Canada or the conscience of Parliament. But we also work for the day when we might have a government that had a conscience of its own. C'est vrai que les Canadiens sont soulagés présentement de se débarrasser d'un gouvernement sans conscience. Mais le nouveau gouvernement n'a pas encore fait ses preuves. Et mon pari, c'est qu'il y aura en masse d'occasions dans le futur où les néo-démocrates vont apprécier et les Canadiens en entier vont apprécier la voix des néo-démocrates au Parlement et hors Parlement. Some might call what I'm talking about the prophetic calling of the NDP. The call to be a voice which looks beyond the shallow forms of self-congratulation that the other political parties are so capable of, that many countries are very capable of. To indulge, it's a call to be a voice that isn't afraid to tell the truth about how we're falling short of our values and to provide leadership on how to more fully realize those values. New Democrats are called, I think, particularly in times of danger or crisis or war, to keep our perspective and not succumb to jingoistic views or the temptation to scapegoat. New Democrats are those who aren't afraid to lay blame where blame is appropriate, but who also are not afraid to ask how we and those whom we count as allies and friends could have done things differently too, and how we have contributed to a situation and some of the problems that we face, and how we can do better moving forward together. De notre époque, parce qu'on sait que c'est qu'en allant au fond des choses et des systèmes qu'on trouve les solutions. The New Democratic Voice is a voice of criticism, and yes, sometimes self-criticism, and that's important too. But this critical stance, remember, is born of the love and the hope that Jack Layton spoke of so eloquently. We need to be a voice of hope and not despair, and a party that judges our success by how many Canadians we can meaningfully engage in that hope and that work for a better world. I can't tell you how much of an honor it has been to serve as your president for the last 5 years. I thank you for that honor. I thank you for your friendship and your solidarity. Merci beaucoup. On continue.